Hi, my name's Scott Hebbard from Sparx Systems, and this webinar will preview the new business model simulation features in Enterprise Architect 14. The outline for today's webinar will include the following topics: learn how to debug and step through a simulation, monitor decisions, tokens, and simulation parameters, and better understand how a business process works using simulation in Enterprise Architect. To illustrate how simulation works, we begin by taking a look at a few examples, including generating a number sequence, simulating and managing an automotive repair shop, and finally managing staff resources for an ICT help desk. The number sequence I plan to simulate is called the Fibonacci sequence. Each value in the Fibonacci sequence is calculated by summing the previous two numbers. The series has countless mathematical, geometric, biological, and business applications. The shapes of spiral galaxies and hurricanes all follow ratios outlined by the Fibonacci sequence. In fact, the Fibonacci series can be found in any number of natural events. A Fibonacci spiral is a series of connected quarter circles drawn inside an array of squares with Fibonacci numbers 4 dimensions. Now let's take a look at our Fibonacci number simulation in the EA example model, which is available with every copy of Enterprise Architect sold. The diagram on screen contains a simple BPMN diagram and the algorithm used to produce a list of numbers known in mathematics as a Fibonacci sequence. The diagram is found in the EA example model under the Model Simulation package, followed by BPSim Models and Fibonacci. The Navigator Toolbar identifies the location of the package you're currently working in and provides options to change a focus to another level of the package's branch and perform relevant operations on the package. The algorithm is displayed for illustrative purposes only. The loop repeats capital N times, which in this particular example is set to 10. Next is calculated by adding the first and second numbers in the sequence. Once we calculate next, which represents the next number in the Fibonacci sequence, we then update first and second using a simple assignment operation. Let's run our Fibonacci number simulation to better understand how BPSim works in Enterprise Architect 14. Select the Simulate ribbon and then select Manage, followed by Open BPSim Manager. We can now select the BPSim artifact on the diagram to see how it's configured. You'll note in the scenario parameters that the JDK and Java runtime environment need to be installed for the simulation to run correctly. Parameters can be added to each element in the simulation or business process diagram, as the case might be. For example, properties have been defined for first, second, and next. It's very easy to add and remove parameters. To demonstrate, I'm going to add a 3-minute processing time delay. I'll delete the existing time parameter to show you how easy it is to recreate. Select an appropriate category. For this particular example, we're going to choose time. Select processing time from the list of available options, noting that there are many other options available to build a comprehensive and realistic simulation. Finally, configure the processing time. I prefer to enter a numeric value and specify the time unit to maintain accuracy and provide realistic processing times. So I've now added a 3-minute processing time to my simulation. In order to run the simulation, select the Execute tab under the BPSim Manager and press the Play button. You'll note that token numbers are displayed on screen in red. Enterprise Architect 14 makes it much simpler to step through the execution of your simulation to better understand what is going on. Let's look at the Step tab to examine the simulation in more detail. Each step is clearly displayed on screen. I can double-click on any step to examine tokens, property parameters, and analyze variables in more detail. Every time I execute a step, Enterprise Architect highlights which part of the business process is currently being executed. This is particularly helpful when debugging a business process, or identifying where a process fails, or identifying unexpected behavior. Let's take a look at property parameters, because each time I step into the simulation, all of the property parameters are updated accordingly. We can see the values of capital N, first, second, the counter value, lowercase n, and next. I find the message column particularly helpful. For example, I can see when any variable changes. For example, next has changed from 2 to 3. I also have the ability to set the simulation speed, so I can speed it up or slow it down as appropriate. We can monitor any changes to the simulation. We can even see when the counter is incremented. The algorithm prints next, which eventually produces our Fibonacci sequence. So what does Enterprise Architect 14 provide for us? Well, we can see which parts of the process are being executed. We can debug each step, checking property parameters. We can filter results to find things that we are interested in. And finally, we can jump to any step in the entire simulation with tokens clearly being displayed on screen. The combination of all these factors makes it very easy to understand how a business process works and for us to understand what's happening in our business process. One of the advantages of simulation in Enterprise Architect is that we do not have to run through every step in chronological order. For example, we might like to observe when the while loop terminates. Simply double-click any step to open that step. Observe how the counter goes from 8 to 9, and the Fibonacci number changes to 144. First and second is updated. However, when the counter becomes 10, the while loop condition is no longer met, and we exit to the end event. In this first example, we've seen how to simulate a simple number sequence, observe changes in property parameters, simulate loops, model counters, processing times, and understand how a Fibonacci number sequence is created based on first principles. This information can be easily adapted to countless real-world problems. Once you understand how to manage and manipulate variables in a number sequence, you can easily adapt and extend these concepts in Enterprise Architect to calculate wages, reduce manufacturing costs, maximize staff hours, or identify the number of widgets created per day on a production line. So while the example shown in this webinar is a simple mathematics problem, its application in real-world problem solving is potentially unlimited. Imagine you own the local automotive repair facility and you want to better understand how your business runs in order to make changes that improve productivity and increase your profit. However, you want to do all of this without impacting current operations. Using BP simulation in Enterprise Architect 14 offers an effective solution that allows you to evaluate some questions, including how many cars can the auto shop process in a day? How many people typically reject an estimate or quote and go elsewhere? And does using less experienced staff have a significant impact on the operation of the business? We can examine variables such as customer wait times, number of rejected estimates, and number of repair issues identified to help us make a better business decision. This example will introduce concepts of probabilities and tokens in simulation. Let's take a look at our BPSim artifact. We can note the start time has been set for 8 a.m. and the duration of the day is 7 hours and 59 minutes. The simulation consists of two separate BPMN diagrams where a repair car subprocess uses probabilities to predict the possibility that extra faults are identified following the inspection of the car. When we execute our simulation, the tokens which represent the different customers are clearly displayed on screen in red. Running the simulation, we can see that in this 8-hour day, only 9 customers ended up paying, while 7 of the 20 rejected the initial estimate. It also shows that some customers were not seen at all. Even this brief analysis might lead you to provide overtime to ensure customers are seen, or take measures to improve the probability that a quote is accepted. I would like to step through the simulation to get a feel for how customers arrive and are processed in the shop. Rather than view in real time, I want to manipulate the speed so I can see the entire day play out in a matter of minutes. Under the play button, I can set the speed for replay. As I increase the number, the simulation speed increases accordingly. Now I can see as each customer moves through the simulation. Note that the absolute and relative times are displayed on screen, so I can see which customers are in the shop at 9:30 a.m. or 10 a.m. in the morning. If I switch to the Property Parameters tab, I can see that for customer number 7, they have one repair issue, and this reduces down to 0. The tokens even show multiple customers are queued up. When the simulation is stopped, I can use column filters to focus on a given customer. For example, I can look at customer number 14. This new feature allows me to see how many repair issues a customer has, how long they are in the shop for, and what path a given customer takes through the business model. I can use simulation to make direct comparison between staff with different levels of experience. I'll show you how to undertake such a comparison. I can copy and paste the BPSim artifact for a mechanic with 5 years experience and make the appropriate changes. I shall name the new element to represent a mechanic that only has a single year of experience, similar to a new apprentice mechanic. Now that we have a new artifact created, we can configure the artifact to better reflect a mechanic that only has a year's experience. In other words, we're going to change the probabilities based on the staff member's mechanical expertise. So the probability that a quote is accepted when a staff member has 5 years experience is 80%, or 0.8. This may come from historical sales data. However, for a new apprentice, this figure may reduce to 70%. We obviously need to update the probability that a quote is being rejected by the corresponding amount so that both probabilities add up to 1. I shall now take a look at the subprocess called Repair Car and update the probability that a new issue is found to 70% and update the no issue found probability accordingly. I can now execute the simulation using the two configurations, allowing me to make comparisons between the two data sets. This in turn can help me make better and more informed business decisions based on the outcomes of the simulation. We can use the context menu to show the BPMN configuration. This allows us to make direct comparisons between the two configurations. Any differences between the two are highlighted in red. So you can see the probabilities that have changed based on staff experience. However, other factors, such as processing time, remains the same. We can also compare the report results. Simply find the reports in the project browser and add them using the context menu. Once again, the differences are highlighted in red. The first thing that stands out is that the more experienced mechanic processed more customers, covering 9 instead of 6. So this particular webinar and example has helped to illustrate how tokens work, how to compare and contrast simulation reports, how to alter probabilities, and how to gain valuable insights into the operation of a business without impacting the business itself, allowing you to experiment and make changes in a low-risk environment. Let's take a look at a final example that is more focused on time management. You'll note that it is also possible to show only the highlighted differences between the two reports. Imagine the scenario where you run an ICT help desk and you've been tasked with the responsibility of reporting on staffing levels. Management is interested in issues such as customer wait times, staff utilization, and how many staff are optimal for the business to run efficiently. Enterprise Architect 14 can help you compare and contrast results for 3 and 5 staff. This analysis can help ensure that staff utilization, budget concerns, and customers are all managed effectively with the simulation information provided by Enterprise Architect 14. I am going to run a business process simulation to compare and contrast 3 and 5 help desk staff. Pressing the play button, I'm going to execute the simulation that represents 3 help desk staff. Tokens on screen show which customers are being served at a given time. Selecting the step tab, I can step through each help desk call. This approach provides a wealth of information to conduct a more detailed analysis. I can see how many of the 3 staff are available at a given time. I can track the absolute arrival and departure time for each customer. I can see when resources are allocated and released. By stepping through the simulation, I can even observe how tokens or customers move through the help desk system, paying particular attention to those customers that have to wait for an available resource. If we look at the configuration of our simulation, we can see a processing time of 10 minutes, and we can see that a new customer arrives every 2 minutes. Once again, this help desk example is part of the EA example model that ships with every copy of Enterprise Architect that is sold, and you can adjust these configurations to suit your own individual needs. Now we want to have a look at comparing 3 help desk staff versus 5 help desk staff. Selecting the BPSim artifact for the 5 help desk staff, I can execute this simulation. Select the Review tab to review the reports from the 2 simulations. To add a configuration, simply right-click the BPSim artifact and use the context menu to select Show BPSim Configuration. When I repeat the process for 5 staff, any differences between the configurations are clearly highlighted in red. So the only meaningful difference in configuration setting is the number of staff. If we open the project browser, we can add custom reports for 3 versus 5 staff. These reports are automatically generated when we execute our simulation. Once again, we can use the context menu to show the BPSim report. All of the differences between the 2 reports are highlighted in red. We can see the average time for a support process is 21 minutes versus 10 minutes. So having 5 staff certainly reduces the time in task and wait times. In fact, with 5 staff, customers never need to wait at all. However, staff utilization is not as high when 5 staff are working rather than 3. You can use filters on each column to find specific parameters you are looking for. For example, let's look at wait times. The thing that jumps out when we do a search for wait times is that customers do not need to wait with 5 staff. If your ICT help desk was mission critical for, say, a hospital or nuclear reactor, this information will be crucial in the decision-making process. So hopefully you can see how you can compare and contrast results from simulations using Enterprise Architect 14. For more information on Enterprise Architect 14 or business process simulation, please visit www.sparxsystems.com.